In this video, we're going to be unboxing the sensor kit that I bought off of Amazon. In this video, we're going to go ahead and do a quick unboxing of this sensor kit that I bought off of Amazon. We're just going to open it up, see what kind of sensors we have in there. Just in case we need any of these sensors for the when doing the tutorials for the Arduino starter kit. So we'll go ahead and we'll do it now in case I need to break into it. So after we run through several tutorials with the Arduino starter kit, we're going to run through some tutorials with the different sensors in this kit so that we can learn how to use some of the many sensors that we have for Arduino. As we talked a little bit about in the series introduction video, part of an electronic system are sensors. You want to be able to read the data around you. And so when we are creating electronic systems for our future aircraft projects, we are going to want to be able to integrate some sensors into the controller as well in Arduino. And so that's what this sensor kit is going to help us learn how to... So this sensor kit is going to help us learn how to start integrating sensors into our Arduino prototype as well as into our future controllers. Let's get to it. If any of you are aerospace engineers or hope to one day become aerospace engineers, go ahead and subscribe to this channel. This channel is dedicated to helping you take your aerospace engineering skills to the next level. Let's get to it. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and start unboxing the sensor kit. Now just right away you notice that it's in one of these plastic organizing cases with a bunch of different compartments on the bottom. This is always a plus if you can get a kit with one of these. It just helps keep your stuff organized and give you a place to put it. So let's go ahead and open it up. Alright, so opening it up, it looks like it has on here the first layer, right? Up at the top it says first layer. So this is going to be the top layer, all the different sensors we have, and then down here it says second layer, so that's going to be all the stuff on the bottom. Looks like there's just a thank you note, thank you card here in with the kit. So this is just kind of what it looks like, just opening it up. Looks like you got a number pad here. And then I've got a bunch of different compartments. And this would be the first layer, and I've got a bunch of different compartments with different sensors in it. So just taking a quick look at it, it is actually organized how the picture looks. So at the top left right here of your picture is going to be the top left here in the kit. So just doing a quick check through, they just all line up. So it looks like it has a photo interrupter and a tap module, temp and humidity. It's got some buzzers. It's got some LEDs, some tilt switches or shock. Buttons, laser emitter. Looks like I have some IR sender receivers, photoresistors, and flash. I got what looks like an avoidance unit, a tracking unit, a linear hall, I've got some sound right here, then some metal touch. So that's on the first level, right? And it just lines up exactly with what this chart says. All right, so let's go ahead and lift the first layer off now and see what's underneath it. So this is what it looks like underneath it. I see that I've got a CD here. I believe this has some tutorials on it. Now it is one of those little tiny CDs, not the full size ones. And it does have on here that it has some PDF. Let's see. It does say on here that it has some PDF code libraries. And then it gives you a link to some of the tutorials. So after you take that CD out, it looks like there's also some pack of resistors here. That is a lot of resistors. Let me see. As you can see, that is a lot of resistors. And then here's just all the components on the bottom level. All right, so up here at the top, I see we have our relay. I see a rotary encoder down here, so that's going to tell you what angle you're at. Right in here, I see you've got some different sensors, like a temperature sensor. You're going to have flame and the magnetic spring. This right here is going to be the ultrasonic sensor, right? It sends out ultrasonic and it receives it. If you remember back in the first video, the eyeballs of that little robot was actually made with this exact unit right here. So these were the eyes of that little robot. Now what's cool is that it also has a joystick in here for us to play with. That might come in handy if we ever look at making a remote controlled aircraft. We might be looking at making our own controller or adapting one from an already made one. All right, then I see that we've got a motion sensor. We have a power supply unit. Then we have this right here. Let me see. This right here would be a water depth sensor. This right here would be a water level sensor. And then we have another one of those little LCD screens. I'm not going to cover all of them now. I feel that'd be way too much all at once. You're probably not going to remember a whole lot if I did do that. So as we do tutorials where I use one or two of them, I'll give a very in-depth explanation of the sensor, what it does, how it works, how we use it, so that we can begin to learn all of these different sensors as we do different projects. All right, go ahead and click that link to the next video. We're going to be looking at the software part of Arduino. We're going to start with getting that installed onto our computer and going over the basic layout of the software that we're going to be using.